There are three major types of decision-making processes. The first one is the inspirational decision-making process. Inspirational decision-making process. The second one is the rational decision-making process. We will talk on each of these in detail. The second one is the rational decision-making process. Then the third one is the irrational decision-making process. So there are three major forms of decision-making processes. We are going to examine each of these in detail, okay? That we may be able to do a number of things, all right? We'll be able to evaluate, okay, the quality of our decision-making processes and also unmask, certain ways through which we can make quality decisions intentionally. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Okay, let me talk about inspirational decision-making process. Okay, to start with, this is the highest and the best quality decision-making process. The inspirational decision-making process is the best, is the highest, and the reason for that is going to become evident very shortly. Please appreciate this. Inspiration is a decision-making process. Inspiration is a decision-making process. I don't have enough time to work on that, but I believe as I continue, this will become evident. But the question is, what is inspiration? And then again, what is intuition? That is the cause of problems to some people. Inspiration, at least from the way I see it in scriptures, is not the same thing as intuition. And I think it's important that we make that decision very clear right now. So what is inspiration? I will define inspiration this way. Inspiration is the voice of God or the voice of the Holy Spirit echoed by the voice of a man. Inspiration is the voice of the Holy Spirit echoed by the voice of the spirit of a man. Echoed by the voice of the spirit of the man. So there are two spirits at work there. Inspiration is the voice of the Holy Spirit that is echoed by the voice of the spirit of man. Job 32 verse 8 establishes firmly that particular truth. But on the other hand, I see intuition. You may not get this from a dictionary perspective anyway. But I see intuition as a voice of the spirit of a man. Intuition is simply the voice, okay, of the spirit of a man. So every man on the face of the earth can have intuition and do have intuition. I think they call it the sixth sense because it doesn't make sense. It's not part of our five senses. Okay? They call it the sixth sense. Am I communicating? Intuition. The spirit of a man can capture ideas. In fact, the psychologists use the word subconsciousness, okay, to describe the activity of the spirit of a man. All right? So intuition is simply the voice of the spirit of a man. But for a believer, you don't have intuition. No. Because a believer has the spirit of God dwelling on his spirit. And that spirit, because it's dwelling on your spirit can see. The spirit of a man is 100% seeing. 100% seeing. But your mind has a voice, which oftentimes can be contrary to the voice of your spirit. In many instances, the voice of the mind, which controls the body, has desires, raises opinions that are completely contrary to the voice of the spirit of the man. And that normally brings your struggles. You have one desire, but what you do can be so conflictful when compared to what you desire to do. Hallelujah. Now, I said that inspiration, that this is the best, isn't it? I mentioned that. Why on earth can we say that this decision-making process is the best? The reason is simple. It is coming from someone who is omniscient. Inspiration is the voice of the Holy Spirit. And the Holy Spirit knows the end from the very beginning. Inspiration is just your spirit echoing the voice of the Holy Spirit. It's actually the Spirit of God that is communicating to you, that is telling you what to do. Proverbs chapter 14 verse 12 says there's a way that seemeth right unto a man. Okay, after all the analysis, after all the deliberations, okay, you think it's right. But the end thereof are the ways of death, ways of destruction. It looks right, but you don't have the capacity to see the end from the very beginning. That's why we can say this decision-making process is the highest, and it's also the best. Hallelujah.